to welcome Adele.
I thought I was going to tumble down the stairs.
Well, yes, I was actually this far from stepping on your dress.
Oh, I know. So
I'm sorry about that. It went well.
I don't
worry. Welcome.
Thanks.
You came back from America now, right?
Yeah, the other day. I'm so jet lagged.
You're jet lagged.
I'm so jet lagged. So. You might ask me a question in a minute and I'll start talking about something totally random.
And you might fall asleep.
I might fall asleep. Yeah. I wouldn't do that. I won't do that. Just wake me up if I do.
I will. when you launched this new album, 25, it was nothing from Adele for years. Mm-hmm. And then it was like 30 seconds.
Yes.
From the first song of the album, yeah, without your name on it. I mean, yeah, it was just your voice singing those first lines.
Yeah, we did an advert that started here in the UK, and it was during a programme called X Factor, yeah, that we have. And, it just came on, and it was just like a black screen with white writing, just with the lyrics of a bit of the first verse of Hello. And then it ended with three dots, as in to be continued. And, I was watching it. I like X Factor, so we were watching it, and I just, like, shit myself. Like, I absolutely lost the plot when it came on. And I got really excited, as if it wasn't me as well. And then afterwards, I'm very new to, like, being on social media. And afterwards, I was, like, trying to check Twitter, but I didn't have a Twitter account, so I just saw what was on there if you're not on there.
You have a Twitter account, right?
Well, I do have one, but I don't have access to it. I don't know the password, so I can't log in to look at stuff. So I was just looking at what was there if, like, your granddad looked on Twitter, you know, sort of like that. And then there was like two tweets. So I was like, oh my God, no one likes it. No one cares. And then my boyfriend, who does have a Twitter account, was like laughing, just going through it all. And it just exploded. And that was like eight weeks ago. It wasn't that long ago that it happened. So since then, so much has happened. So it was great, the advert.
I'm getting curious here. Why don't you have access to Twitter? Is that...
Because I might say something stupid. You'll learn during our conversations that every now and then I say something stupid.
I mean, yeah, I think it would be a great idea because I think everybody on Twitter is saying stupid things, you know.
Yeah,
that's what Twitter is about.
Yeah, but I know, but I don't have like I like to try and be a little bit. Not give everything away all the time, yeah, so that I can surprise people with things sometimes. So if I had a password to Twitter, maybe I'd be on it all the time, which means that no one would miss me.
Yeah.
Because
your last album, 21, was it broke all records. It was like the biggest British album in this century. And it was an amazing success, and an act impossible to follow in a way.
Yeah.
How confident have you been that you would manage to do it?
I mean, I wouldn't say I'm like out of the woods or anything with it, but like for a little while I was a bit like, I don't know if I'm ever going to be able to follow this up with anything that I like, that I feel is good enough to put out. But that only lasted for about a month, where I was like, I don't know if I can do this. And then I just realised that I can't top 21. But once I let go of that, and also once I realised that I don't want to be in the same state of mind I was when I wrote 21, because it was a miserable one, that I let go and I was like, I was just writing music for fun, and which it felt a lot like I was making my first album again, because I was just doing it because I wanted to, rather than, oh, let's try and follow it up with something, you know. And so I got over it, and I'm fine, and I was not expecting... This is, like, madder than 21.
Tell me about... Tottenham. I mean, you grew up in Tottenham, which is a part of London, right?
Yeah, or, yeah, North London.
And growing up there, you grew up with your mother. Mm-hmm. She was quite young when she had you.
She was.
How was that upbringing? How was that?
Oh, it was great. We didn't have very much, but I had a lot of love, which I think now that I'm a parent, that really is the best thing you can give your kid. Mm-hmm. And I always felt loved, and she always... I think her, like the youth in her, like it was just that everything was fun. Everything was always fun. And I remember being about 15 or 16. I wasn't in Tottenham at that point, but and me like starting to write songs and stuff, and me being like, I'm writing an album. And she was like, yeah, I know. It was never, yeah, I know. It was, you know, she was never patronized. She was like, yeah, I know. Like, I can't wait to hear it one day. So she was never like, oh, maybe have a backup plan. You know, she was like, I know you are, and I'm looking forward to it.
What's your first musical memory? You have such a thing?
Yeah, she used to take me to a lot of gigs. My first, like, really clear memory was a concert of The Beautiful South that she took me to at Brixton Academy in South London. And she snuck me in like, a trench coat, like underneath her coat. Like,
how old were you then?
I think I was, like, three. Three or four, and it was amazing. It was incredible. And then another one, she went to see The Cure, Infinity Park, and that was a massive show. And it was incredible. I don't think I was snuck into that one. I think I was allowed into that one. Mm. I think I must have been five. But she was the biggest Jeff Buckley fan. Mm. So I just remember the Grace album all the time growing up. It was just like, I'd hear it like when she'd put me to bed and she'd go and have her evening to herself. Like, I just remember hearing it.
From your point of view, who's got the greatest, who's the greatest male singer in the world today?
Today? Mm. Probably Bruno Mars. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I worked with Bruno Mars. And that's why I would say he's the best male singer, because he was like this far away, singing full voice at me, and he was hitting notes I couldn't even dream of. He'd be like, "Oh, sing up here," and I was like, "I can't sing up there. Like, bring it down an octave." Like, you know, he was just amazing, and he could do so many things with his voice. So we were doing like loads of duets in the studio, like just mucking around, like singing like all different types of songs.
What do you miss from your former life?
Just the like innocence of it, I think. I mean, not that I'm terrible or anything like that, but just the lack of responsibility and basically living someone else's life while living your own, because, you know, you live your parents' lives, your guardians' lives, and they take care of all the really boring stuff while you just live a life with your friends and it doesn't have that many consequences. So I think the lack of responsibility I really miss. And that's not to say that I'm talking about my responsibility of being a parent or being successful or anything like that. It's just that things get really serious when you become an adult, and you don't realise you become an adult until randomly one day when you're doing something and it comes and like says hello to you like out of the blue, and it scared the life out of me. It's scared, and I'm not old, don't get me wrong, I'm not old at all, but I feel it. I feel old, and I feel like I'm only going to get older, not to depress you. When you're, like, 13, 14, you're only ever getting one step closer to, like, going out, travelling, having sex, having a drink. Like, that's what you're doing. And now it's like...
Now...
I've done everything. What else have I got left to do?
Now, I mean, now you,
in
can't,
life.
You can't even send out a tweet, you know?
I can't even send out
the
a tweet.
The consequences are too big.
Things have nothing to do with my work and my, you know, my music. It's just like real life, and it's funny because all my friends were all between like 26 and 31, and we're all having meltdowns. We're all like, what do we do? Am I supposed to have a baby? Should I get married? Should I buy a house? Should I get a dog? None of us know what to do.
I'm 49.
You've got five kids. You're a nutter.
Yeah. Well... I'm just old.
You're not old. How old are you?
Well, if I'm 49, if I'm not old, then you are certainly not old.
You look 49. I know I'm not old. I just, you know, it's a shock.
We're not old, you know?
We're not old.
I mean, I only know old people. They're really old, you know? you've said once, the more success you have, the less life you have.
The smaller your life gets.
The smaller your life gets.
Yeah. My life's still wonderful and it's still blossoming and all that, but I just feel like the bigger your career gets, the smaller your life gets. And I remember seeing it in... It's not said like that, but, you know, Devil Wears Prada, the film, when, like, you know, she's, like, breaking up with her boyfriend. Everything to do with everything I ever do is based on a film. Like, literally, I have little snippets of films. Like, Rolling in the Deep was about Mark Wahlberg floating in the sea during the perfect storm. When he's reading the love letter, like, that's what that's about. So, Rolling in the Deep's a bit... Yeah, that's, like, what I envisioned when I was singing it.
So, which film is Hello?
Hello's not really one. Hello didn't really have one, but, like, the saying of, you know, the bigger your career gets, the smaller your life gets, in Devil Wears Prada, and her boyfriend's, like, getting annoyed. Yeah. And someone else says to her, like, when your whole life goes up in smoke, you drew a promotion. And I remember being like, what does he mean by that? And then I just, as my career got bigger on 21, my life didn't go up in smoke at all, and I love the opportunity and my life. I love everything about it. But it's just, you know, some people get quite fazed by someone's success, so I had to sort of be a bit like... distance myself from a lot of people that I've known my whole life and just make my circle a bit smaller.
Is the project for you is to sort of try to maintain normality in all this?
Well, I think that's the main goal, because I don't know how I'm going to write records that people can relate to and enjoy if I'm living some mad life.
And the thing is also that it's a very seductive business.
Yeah, I mean, that's why that's why I'm not into it, because it tries to seduce you and charm you, and I'm like, you're not real. Like, but also, it's like everyone, you know, there is... I like coming in and out of it because I feel like I can enjoy it more if I'm not in it constantly. But also, it always goes. Fame always goes. And I find it so tragic when you see people that have no idea that they're not what they used to be, and it's like, I don't want to get to the point where, like, no one wants to come to my shows or listen to my music and I don't realise it, and I think I'm firing my manager and stuff like that, thinking it's his fault. It's like, it goes. Well,
that's the thing, that you get a lot of yay-sayers around you.
Oh, I don't. They all say no all the time, as do I. I say no all the time, too.
Yeah, OK, so you have... Who would say no to you?
My manager, my best friend, my boyfriend. Everyone, really. And that's what I want, though. I don't want people, like... blowing smoke up my ass, because I've seen people that surround themselves with yes people and they make shit records and they're shit people. And I'm not having it. I'm not having it.
What you and I have in common is that we have a 3-year-old.
Yes.
Actually, I have always that in common with most of my guests because I have children all ages, but... and I wonder, how do you sleep?
Well, he didn't sleep for, like, the first 9 months, so I thought my body was shutting down. And he's a really good sleeper now, but with the travelling, like, I've probably only had about 13 hours sleep in, like, a week, because of the jet lag, and then he's fine now, and I'm just, like, wide awake at, like, 4 in the morning now that I've got him through it. But, you know, it's hard. I had my balance before, like when I was making the record and like being a mum, and now I'm just like I need to readjust my balance a little bit to make sure that I have some me time as well. Because right now I do my stuff with my work, and then all of my other time is for him, which is great. But like, I need to just like just chill and like hang out with just my friends for just for a couple of hours here and there. But I'm sleeping. I'm all right.
Are you the one doing the lullabies?
Yeah, I mean, I don't do anything special. We just do, like, I'm sure you guys have them as well, like Twinkle Twinkle and Row Row Your Boat. But if I try and sing him anything that's actually amazing, he just tells me to shut up. But I think it's because he doesn't know the songs as well, whereas he knows the lullabies.
So which one is your favourite?
Twinkle Twinkle. You must know that.
No.
What?
We don't have it in Scandinavia.
You don't have Twinkle Twinkle?
Do we?
You cheat, trying to make me sing. I'm going to sing for you later.
The fact is, we have... Do we have Twinkle Twinkle?
Yes.
I think they have it in Sweden. I'm Norwegian, you know.
OK. They have it in Norway. Come on. I bet, like, when I go to Norway, I could sing it to, like, a 3-year-old, and they'd be like, yeah, get it.
I enjoy... Because for me... singing lullabies is it's like the children. I mean, her room is the new shower for me.
Okay, yeah.
You know, I sound so
great.
You've
got all your inhibitions go in her room.
Yeah, I sound so great, you know. And sometimes she pretends.
I don't sound very
asleep.
Good when I'm singing lullabies. It's really weird, like twinkle, twinkle. It's not great. It's like I'm just going through the motions.
So you don't have the build up.
So there's no build up. Yeah, I don't sound like a singer when I'm singing nursery rhymes. No.
Very disappointing.
Do you want to give it a go? Do you want to have your moment and sing a song for us?
The plan was that you were going to sing.
Well, can you sing us one? Sing me one that I wouldn't know that you sing to your daughter.
Do I know any English one? No, you have to take
no,
over.
I'm sing an English one. Sing whatever you sing her.
Okay, yeah. But that's a Norwegian one.
Okay, I want to hear it.
Vem kan segla for utan vind? Vem kan ro utan åra? No.
That's lovely.
No, thank you so much.
Oh.
Now it's your turn, please.
Twinkle little star, how I...
Come on, you're better than that.
That's honestly how we do it. That's honestly how me and my kid do it, honestly. You sounded wonderful. What a lovely little note you are.
Thank you so much, Adele. It's wonderful to have you on the show.